Do you know what will happen if detergent is mixed with gasoline? In this video, I will show you a mixture that people think doesn't make sense, but this mixture can be very useful for everyday needs. The first step is to prepare gasoline. Gasoline in my country is colored blue. Maybe in your country it is different. Then prepare a container, or you can use an old jar. Pour a little gasoline into the container you have prepared. I pour it in a small amount, or later it can be adjusted to your needs, then prepare the styrofoam. Items that are usually just thrown away or can be called trash. Mix this styrofoam into a container containing gasoline and a physical reaction will occur, not a direct combustion chemical reaction, because gasoline is a non-polar hydrocarbon solvent that is able to dissolve polystyrene. Which country are you watching this video from? Leave a comment below and let me know. I'm always happy to see how we can connect with each other from all around the world. Styrofoam is actually 95% air and only about 5% solid polystyrene. When exposed to gasoline, the loose bonds between the polystyrene and the air break down, causing the styrofoam to melt and shrink into small, sticky clumps. The dissolved polystyrene turns into a thick, gel-like mass. This substance is extremely sticky and can adhere strongly to other objects. After mixing it well, the results of this mixture are really amazing. You can actually use this thick liquid as a substitute for glue, but I won't make glue. Add a few spoons of detergent to this mixture. Now I'm going to try adding detergent to the gasoline and styrofoam mixture we made earlier. Many people might be curious about whether a new reaction or even a major change will occur after this liquid comes into contact with the detergent. Actually, detergent can't dissolve gasoline or styrofoam because they have different properties. However, when added, we can see how the liquid changes in appearance and texture, becoming slightly different when stirred. From what was initially just a thick lump of gasoline and styrofoam, after adding detergent, the liquid looks more unique, resembling a gel or glue. You can store this mixture in a tightly sealed container and use it anytime you need. But before we apply this mixture, I want to show you another creative idea that will absolutely blow your mind. Have you ever wondered what happens if you mix gasoline with cement? It sounds impossible, even a little crazy, but trust me, the result will truly surprise you. Stay tuned, because I'll show you step by step how to make it. Prepare a container. You can use an old jar or any other container you have. Next, fill the container with gasoline. Then, add the cement you've prepared into the container with gasoline. Pour it in gradually, spoon by spoon, so the mixture blends together properly. Normally, you might see cement being mixed with water, but this time it's different. I'm showing you how cement can actually dissolve in gasoline. The mixture of gasoline and cement produces something very different from the usual cement and water mix, which normally hardens into a solid. When mixed with gasoline, the texture becomes more liquid, sticky, and it cannot harden like regular cement. This mixture looks unique because gasoline acts as a solvent, preventing the cement from forming strong bonds like it does with water. This is what makes the gasoline and cement mixture so different, giving it unusual properties compared to regular cement mixtures. Once the cement and gasoline are thoroughly mixed, prepare a container with a lid. Make sure the mixture is fully blended for the best results. Spoon some of the mixture into the prepared container. Then close it tightly. Next, add gasoline to the remaining cement mixture. Then, prepare a material that's easy to find around the house, styrofoam. Slowly add the styrofoam into the gasoline and cement mixture, making sure everything mixes together properly. It's important to know that styrofoam will dissolve when mixed with gasoline. This happens because gasoline acts as a strong chemical solvent, breaking down the light and porous structure of styrofoam. As the styrofoam dissolves, it turns into a sticky, thick material that can blend seamlessly with the cement mixture. This process gives the mixture a unique texture, not only denser, but also more flexible and easier to shape compared to regular cement. Moreover, the reaction between gasoline, cement, and styrofoam creates properties that are very unusual, completely different from conventional cement mixtures. That's why this combination is so fascinating to observe and produces results that are truly unique in various experiments or creative projects. As an example, this mixture can be used to repair a broken bucket. I have a broken bucket, and now I'll show you how to fix it using this mixture. The first step is to sand the area of the bucket that needs repair. Sanding helps the mixture adhere perfectly to the bucket's surface. After sanding the damaged area of the bucket, the next step is to apply tape to the inside of the broken section. The tape acts as a barrier, preventing the sticky mixture from flowing inside the bucket and ensuring it stays exactly where it is needed. Once the tape is in place, carefully pour the gasoline cement styrofoam mixture onto the broken area. Use a spatula or your hands to spread it evenly, making sure all gaps and cracks are fully covered. Because of its sticky and slightly flexible texture, the mixture adheres well to the bucket surface and can effectively fill irregular shapes. This process ensures a strong and stable patch while creating a smooth and even surface, making the repair both functional and visually neat. After the mixture has been applied and smoothed out, leave the repaired area to set for 24 hours. This allows the mixture to harden completely and adhere firmly to the bucket, ensuring a durable and long-lasting repair. After 24 hours, remove the tape from the inside of the bucket. Now you can see the results of the repair. The outcome is truly impressive. The mixture has hardened perfectly and adheres firmly to the bucket surface. If desired, you can sand the outer area of the patch to make it smoother and more even. Keep in mind, the appearance of the patch is not the main focus. The primary purpose is functionality. This mixture is designed to repair and hold water, not to provide a perfect visual finish. Next, I will test the repaired bucket to see how well the patch holds. The goal is to ensure that the repair is watertight and that the mixture prevents any leaks. This test demonstrates the effectiveness of the gasoline cement styrofoam mixture in repairing a broken bucket, as well as the strength and durability of the patch that has been created. Take a close look at the patched area. There are no signs of water leakage at all. This clearly indicates that the repair is completely sealed and there are no leaks. The result is very satisfying because the mixture, once fully dried, becomes extremely hard and strong. With this level of strength, the patch not only holds water effectively but can also withstand everyday use without easily breaking or cracking. This demonstrates that the gasoline cement styrofoam mixture is indeed highly effective for repairing broken buckets or similar types of damage. In fact, I also tried using this mixture to fill a hole in a wall, and the results were very satisfying. The mixture adheres perfectly and is able to seal the hole without any difficulty. This demonstrates that the gasoline cement styrofoam mixture is not only effective for repairing broken buckets, but can also be used to fix walls that are leaking or cracked. With its sticky and strong texture, this mixture provides a practical and durable solution for various home repairs. Next, when you are outdoors and want to build a campfire or burn wood, sometimes the wood can be difficult to ignite. You don't need to worry, because the first mixture we made, cement and gasoline, can help. This mixture has been left in a sealed container for 24 hours to see whether it would harden or not. The result is that the mixture is still usable and retains its flammable properties, making it perfect for helping to ignite wood. Its sticky and flammable texture is similar to paraffin, making it extremely useful when you are outdoors, such as camping, hunting, or engaging in other outdoor activities. You can store this mixture in a sealed container, which is much safer than carrying pure gasoline. Imagine if you carried gasoline and it spilled inside your backpack, your other equipment could get soaked, which is very dangerous. Unlike pure gasoline, this mixture is safer, more practical to carry anywhere, and still very effective for helping to start a fire. In addition, the first mixture we made earlier, a combination of detergent, gasoline, and styrofoam, can also be used as an alternative fuel source when you're doing outdoor activities, such as camping, fishing, or other fieldwork. This mixture ignites easily and burns steadily, making it useful in emergencies or situations where you don't have access to conventional fuel. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell so you won't miss our next creative ideas. Share this video with your friends or family, it might be useful for them too. See you in the next video.